YouTube friends, how's it going? Alright, I just did a live stream on my Instagram, so if you're hopping from Instagram over to YouTube, welcome back. For those of you guys that are just joining the YouTube live stream, welcome to my gallery exhibition titled Paintings of Our Parks. This is an exhibition of my oil and acrylic paintings inspired by landscapes in our national parks. So the first thing you do when you walk in, this gallery is located in Pittsburgh. The show is up until October 22nd. It'll be closed tomorrow though because I have to do some work in the studio to get caught up on some things. But anyway, it's open Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, over the last 3 days, you can see. Nate is my husband, he's holding the camera, so if you hear another person talking, that's my camera guy. Okay, over here, when you first walk in, awesome. We have some prints. The originals for these pieces already sold, so the prints available are up. These are all small ones, less than 10 inches, 10 and a half by 8 is the biggest one over here. These prints all vary from $20 to $35. They're all available to purchase. If you're interested, you can email me info@stephmoracafineart.com. That is my email. Or you can visit my website, stephmoracafineart.com, and contact me there. There's a 9 by 12 inch print up there. I have little guest booklets and candy. Over here we have my, just like some memories from visiting the parks. So we have some of the park newspapers from the national parks I visited. I have my little national park passport book from, when you go visit national parks, they sell these little books and you can stamp in the visitor center all the parks that you visited. We also have a coloring book. I know some of you guys have purchased this coloring book. Thank you. And it sounds like you're enjoying them so far. Thank you so much. I'm glad that you like these. This is Art of Our Parks, my coloring book. These are coloring pages based off of my paintings. A lot of these paintings are in the exhibition here, and some of them have sold. But these are just coloring pages so that you guys can also color and enjoy the landscapes of the national parks. And then at the back of the coloring book, I have my paintings that inspired other coloring books. Those coloring books are $10 on Amazon. I can leave a link for those in the description under this video after this video is done stream. So, before we dive into the show, here's my statement. This is just me talking about the show in paper form, basically. So I already talked a little bit about this. But basically, this exhibition combines two of my passions, spending time in nature and creating captivating landscapes. My goals for the exhibition are to showcase the magnificent public landscapes in our country, hopefully enticing viewers to get outside and appreciate these landscapes in person, and two, to evoke cheerful emotions for my viewers as they reminisce on their own travels to these national parks. Let's see, and then I just talk a little bit more about the background and my process for creating these paintings, which I'll talk about during the show. So we'll be carrying over this and talk a little bit about the artist, talking about favorite national parks, and how I got into painting. I have some videos on my channel about this. If you're interested in writing more about my history and my background as an artist. Over here, we just have some more of my little memories from visiting the parks. This is a National Park Service map with some of the stickers that I collected at these parks. We also have my postcards. I collect postcards at parks as well. And over here, we have the park brochures. When you visit the park, you stop at the entrance station, they give you those little brochures. That's what those are for. Alright, so starting off with the original paintings, if anybody says anything in the chat, does the chat show up on there? No?
I don't know.
Alright, if you guys have any questions, leave a comment in the under the video, after the video is done, because Nate's not as familiar with YouTube and he's not sure how to get the chat to pop up. So thank you guys. If you have anything in the chat, I'll see if I can catch those later and get back to you. But if you do have a question or comment, leave a comment under this video. Alright, so this original painting is driftwood and shell sculpture, 36 inches by 24 inches. This was inspired by Dry Tortugas National Park in Florida. So somebody randomly just went and put these conch shells on this driftwood, and usually when I see stuff like that at national parks, I knock it down because it's not natural, and it's something that people put there because they thought it was fun, but to me it takes away from the experience. But in this situation, I thought these were really beautiful, and I wanted to take a photo of them and turn it into a painting. It's just a really nice layout with the ocean in the background, with that emerald color, and then we had like some purples and blues and browns of the wood, and then like warmer colors up in the conch shells, and it's just a really nice balance of the way that the layout of the driftwood was, so I wanted to turn that into a painting. That's where we go next. Sure.
Okay. I was saying that way.
I think the first step is.
Also, I think I got the chat showing up now. Elf Lord's Journey had said that he got his he got the
coloring book
and it looked awesome.
Very good. All right, thanks. Okay, this we got the chat to work, so you guys can comment in the chat now too. All right, this one is Pine Cones and Pine Creek Canyon. This original painting sold. I started this one by referencing a photo I took in portrait mode on my phone. So I kept the foreground pine cones in focus and then kind of made the background fuzzier and out of focus, having less contrast too. So it really draws your attention right here, but you still get more of the whole atmosphere with the colors in the background. This one was inspired by Zion National Park. All right, coming over here, let's start right here. This is Jenny Lake, is the title of this painting. It's 8 inches by 10 inches. And this one was inspired by Jenny Lake in Grand Teton National Park. I created this painting in plein air, which means I stood there in person at Jenny Lake and had my little brochure box and did some plein air painting, just painting exactly what I saw in front of me. It was a smoky day with a wildfire air there, so the sky is a little bit gray and we lose some of the colors in the mountains, but it helps to set the mood and it does create more depth in the landscape when you have that wildfire smoke in the background. All right, next we have Joshua Tree. This is called the Joshua Tree. This is Joshua Tree National Park in California, and it just depicts a Joshua Tree. Here we have Harper's Prism. This one was inspired by the Harper's Walking Trail in Zion National Park. So in this park, there's like a 3-mile walking trail. It's supposed to be paved, right? Yeah, it's like a paved, wider trail. It just goes through Zion Canyon. It's relatively flat. We're trying to remember if it's paved. I'm pretty sure it's paved.
Was that the one that was paved or the other one? Was that the one that was paved or was it the other one?
We were riding our bikes on it and we go over the bridge. Well, this is one of the bridges you go over. This is the view. And you can see all of the colors in this painting. The rocks have that reddish color. And then you start to get a little more tans and purples and snow and shadows in the background. A little bit of purple and blue down here. And the grasses are more of that golden brown color. A little bit of green in the shrubbery. So even though this scene is in March, when things usually get a little less colorful in the landscape, this one was a really colorful landscape, and it's very going to create that cool. All right, next. This one will quite a little bit that way. All right, bring it over here. This one is Autumn Morning in Acadia. This original painting already sold. This is oil on canvas. This painting depicts sunrise time just before the sun is like all the way up, like the sun's just coming up and warming up this ridge here, you can see. And it's an autumn scene in Acadia National Park in Maine. This was kind of like an outline, is where we were sitting to watch the sunrise, and as we were walking back to our vehicle after watching the sunrise, I snapped a few photos looking this direction and wanted to turn that into a painting. And I did this one. I did some of this painting process on YouTube videos last year.
Do those?
These ones? All right, we're doing a different path than I took for my Instagram comments. All right, so this one is, these four paintings here are all acrylic on canvas panel. These four paintings are all a little bit less detailed, a little bit more expressive with the brushwork in general, especially these two. These are all different national parks. This one is inspired by Grand Canyon National Park. This one's titled Grand Canyon Twilight, acrylic on canvas panel. This is Yosemite Falls around the River Bend, inspired by Yosemite in California. And we have the Merced River here wrapping around the bend, and then you can see Upper Yosemite Falls in the background there. Nice sunny day. This one is Delicate Arch in Arches National Park in Utah. This is a sunset time, so it really makes makes those rugs glow, nice vibrant colors. And then over here we have Autumn Stroll at Jordan Pond. This is just like a nice autumn sunny day in Acadia National Park in Maine. This one is an oil on canvas. I also built the frame for this one. This painting is inspired by Grand Teton National Park. Instead of facing the mountain range that usually inspires everybody's paintings, I wanted to turn in the opposite direction and face more of the plains and get more of that traditional Wyoming landscape. And then we just have a statement a little about the artist here today, a little bit smaller. Heard in the noise over there, there is another, there's like artist loft studio over there. Okay, let's start here.
Do we do these?
So this is one of my favorite paintings. This one is Vernal Fall in Yosemite National Park. This is a big 300-something-foot waterfall. I actually used to work about a quarter mile down the trail from this waterfall, on this trail. This one is just a special waterfall to me. And it's really cool how the waterfall changes throughout the year. So in the late summer, or late spring, early summer, this waterfall has more water than this usually. Mist.
Alf said love this painting.
Oh yeah, nice. Elf likes this too. So there's a lot of water rushing down the waterfall and it's creating all this mist. That's why it's called a mist trail. So the water's coming up and you guys are taking up the steps around and up to the top of this waterfall. And then by the end of summer, early autumn, the water's way less water than this. By, you know, October, there's usually just a tiny little trickle because all of the water that feeds this waterfall comes from snow melts. Any snow left to melt before the snow really comes in again right before winter. So it's pretty cool to see how this waterfall changes throughout the year. Are they in here? Yep. All right, we're going to move. This one is Park Avenue in Arches National Park. So this is, as we were leaving Arches National Park, this section of the park doesn't have any arches in it, but it is called Park Avenue. Walk through. These are really like hundreds of feet tall rock faces that just look massive when you're standing there. But for this one, I was really inspired by all the colors in the sky. So the sun was setting over here, creating really nice colors and light on the clouds over here, just like way out past the park, and it's raining. So the sun's warming up these clouds. You can see all the rain coming down, and it's just glistening. It was so beautiful to see in person. So had to turn that one into it. All right, this one is Painted Canyon Sunset. This is inspired by the Painted Canyon area in North Dakota in Teddy Roosevelt National Park. So this one, we were just sitting there with our little camp chairs watching the sunset this day. It was just a nice peaceful moment, beautiful, colorful landscape with the sunset.
On the other side. Did you do the...
All these four.
Okay.
But now I'll move here. Yeah. Okay. So three of the four here are plein air paintings, which means I painted them in nature as I saw in front of me. This one is the TA Molten Bore. Also good. Okay, this one is the TA Moulton Barn in Grand Teton National Park in Wyoming. Yeah, this one I just sat there in a little camp chair and worked on this oil on canvas panel and whipped that one out about 2 hours, trying to focus more on like the colors and get that movement in the clouds rather than focusing on the details. This one I did focus a little more on the details. I started this one in plein air in Zion National Park. This is the Virgin River. And the painting was finished from my art studio, so I added more detail and these intricate little lines of the running water to create that movement from the studio. But I started it in plein air to get the colors and the lights in here. Okay. Over here we have Ponderosa Point at Bryce. This one was inspired by Bryce Canyon National Park in Utah. This one was not completed in plein air. It was all done in the studio, and this one I really liked the warm colors in the foreground, and then it just kind of fades into the background, losing some of that warmth, getting more of the like, cool reds and purples, and then the blues, and yeah, just full range of color, really nice colorful landscape. This one's Bridge Mountain in Zion. So this one was just south of my campground, the Watchman Campground in Zion National Park. Just walked over to a spot where I could just paint without anybody talking to me. Sometimes I have days where I'm like, I just want to paint and I don't really want to talk to anyone. And this was one of those days. So I did that, and this is the side of Bridge Mountain that most people don't see. Most people see it from the other side as they're driving the Zion Mount Carmel Tunnel Road. That takes you to that tunnel. And you can see the other side of this from that road, but most people don't see it from this angle, so I wanted to paint something a little more unique there. Okay? What'd you look at? Nate's bored, he's done this twice already.
No. No, did we do those ones over there already? Just keep going.
Okay. Yeah, so these are prints. The original paintings for these already sold. The prints here already sold. This is Schwabecker Landing in Grand Teton National Park. This print is a base for Bass Harbor Headlight in Maine, in Acadia National Park. The original sold and the print sold. Here we have two prints that are still available. This is Canyonlands Sunset in Canyonlands National Park. And this is Grand Teton. This is the Snake River overlooking Grand Teton National Park. All right, we did Vernal Pool. We did that one. Here we have Alpine Pond and Meadow. This one was inspired by Glacier National Park. This is Logan Pass. This is the area, like at that high point on the Going to the Sun Road in Glacier National Park. So I hiked to Hidden Lake, and along that hike we saw this beautiful calm water area, big rocks and the trees, and then behind us there was a big boulder field and there were pika going meep from the boulder field, so that was always
fun. What was that?
Meep. That's always fun. They're one of my favorite animals. Very excited to be there. When we were in Glacier, we stood for like a half hour on a few of the trails just watching the pika. And people walking by were like, what do you see? And I'm like, a pika. And they're like, and then I keep walking, I'm like, it's a pika! Alright, so here we have Winter Creek. This is not a national park, this is actually a landscape in Maryland close to Deep Creek Lake at a state park. This one I just put in the show because it helped with the symmetry of this wall, so that's why this one's in the show. This one did already sell in the show, so I'm glad we're doing it. Alright, next we have Compliments of Sunset Point. This one was inspired by Bryce Canyon National Park. It's titled Compliments of Sunset Point because we have the complementary colors going on here. And yeah, super colorful. If you've never been to Bryce Canyon National Park, all the rocks are this like really brilliant orange golden color, and the hoodoos are these formations from all of the erosion and weathering. They're really beautiful to see in person if you haven't done that yet. This is Lower Yellowstone Falls. Self-explanatory. Lower Yellowstone Falls in Yellowstone National Park in Wyoming. This is one of my more detailed paintings, oil and canvas. And yeah, I really like this one. I always feel like the clouds look like they're moving when I look at that. This one is Navajo Arch. This is Nate, the camera guy's favorite painting in the show. And he said this is his favorite because it has a spiritual feel. He really liked this place in Arches National Park. This arch, you walk under this arch and there's like just some sticks and there's a tree like this in this little cove and like a little bit of light comes and just like lands on that tree. But I wanted to get more of the arch into the painting. But yeah, it's a nice spot there. This one is Iceberg Lake in Glacier National Park. This is oil on canvas, 8 inches by 8 inches. So I just did a video about this on our channel. I have another channel called Travel Season where we do like all of my national park trips and other travel adventure type stuff. So if you're interested in that, you can check out our channel called Travel Season. But I just did a video about our hike to this lake. And then this is the painting I created after coming back to the studio.
Our hike and how we saw a bear.
Yeah, we saw a grizzly bear there. It was exciting. All right, bringing it over here. This one is Autumn Day at Dark Hollow Falls. This one is in Shenandoah National Park in Virginia. We visited this park a couple years ago, around this time that year, so mid-October, and we had the brilliant colors of autumn leaves and the trees. the sun lighting things up here, and then everything in the foreground is more in shadow, so you get a little bit more of the cooler colors down here. Just pulls your attention up to the sunny part, so, yeah. Nice, happy, colorful.
Great artworks. Very nice.
Nice, who said that?
Davey.
Davey, hi, Davey. Very good. Okay, over here. Nick doesn't know who you guys are, but I know. Alright, this is a print. This original painting already sold. Those prints over there were giclée prints, so giclée prints use a printer with more colors and ink. This is just a poster print, so it doesn't have the colors that are true to the original painting quite as much, but it still gets that whole feel for the scene. This original painting was much smaller. The original was 20 by 16 inches, and it's in a frame, and that print is available. This one is Perforated Pool. I believe I did this one on my YouTube channel a couple years ago. This one is inspired by a hot spring in Yellowstone National Park. And I wanted to focus more on just like the close-up of it and not get like that full landscape. It doesn't need to include the sky and everything. Just focus more on the beautiful colors in the hot spring. And there's like a little bench here. It gets deeper there and kind of fades off into the back. So there's that. And then over here, we have these two paintings are from Great Sand Dunes National Park in Colorado. I may have done painting tutorials on these. I don't remember. I may have. Okay, well, these two paintings are put together just to show the two different times of day in the National Park. They're not sold as a set, they're sold separately. But this one is the sunset. So the sun is on the west, casting light and shadows on that side. And then here's the sunrise, so there's some mountains over here. That's why it's all in shadow down here. It's in light starting over here, so the sun's up here, creating light and then shadows on that side.
David said faves for the mountain artworks. Really great.
Nice, very good, thank you. All right, and then we got two more pieces. One is a big one.
Do that one first.
Okay. Yeah. All right, this one is Mountain Cascade. This was one of my favorites in this exhibition. This painting sold as well. This is 8 inches by 10 inches, oil on canvas. Inspired by Glacier National Park in Montana. And then last but not least, we have the big one. This one is Angel's Landing. It's 4 feet by 5 feet, so 60 inches by 48 inches, oil on canvas. I started this painting in 2018. This was one of the first videos I did on this YouTube channel. and I was planning to get that all done in a year and like break it up into like 8 parts. And I think I got to part 3 and then I let it go and I didn't touch this painting for 2 years. And then I came back this year and I finished the painting in time for the exhibition. It took a lot of my sleep away from me the last couple weeks before the show, but we got it done and I'm happy with it for the exhibition. So this one is Angel's Landing in Zion National Park. This is Zion Canyon down here. It's all in shadow, it's early morning, and the sun is up, and it's warming up all the stuff in the background. Hasn't quite come around this ledge yet. And then the Angel's Landing hiking trail goes around here, off the canvas, and then out back, and then you kind of make your way up to the top of that guy, and it's a pretty fun, exciting hike. Definitely not the safest hike in the National Park system, but it's a fun one. So with this giant painting, that concludes my exhibition. I hope you guys enjoyed looking at all of my paintings inspired by our National Parks. If you have any comments or questions for me, leave a comment under this video. And if you're interested in any of these original paintings, again, you can email me info@stephmoracafineart.com. I will leave that in the description under this video as well. And I think that's it. Yep. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.